Hello and welcome to Wildlife Cam. On Sunday, a big cold front moved in, so we had 4 days of cold, overcast, windy weather and a couple of days of rain. Luckily, the elephants don't seem to mind the cold weather too much. In fact, I think they prefer it. And also because rain puddles are not good enough for them to drink from, we still had a lot of elephants at the waterhole. And this is a green-backed heron. Quite handy to have one around because the fish are breeding so successfully, we need something to thin the population a little bit. Now they can sit in one place like that for a very long time. They're very patient, but what they're also known to do is to use bait. They'll grab little bits of bread or other debris, they'll drop it into the water, and when the fish comes for the bait, they'll catch the fish, which is very unusual in birds. And there you see he's catching a fish. We had about 50 millimeters of steady rain over 2 days, which is going to be very good for the bush and hopefully leads to a population explosion of a variety of insects and other creepy crawlies, although I'm probably in a minority for wishing that. This elephant, the bigger one, is missing the end of her trunk, most likely caught in a poacher's snare. But they are quite adaptable and they can manage all right without the end. Our wonky tusked friend is back after a while. He can stab you around the corner. Very stubborn little elephant. This refuses to move out of the way of the two bigger ones. We've recently had some of our dirt roads fixed up with some new reddish brown sand, and so judging by the coloration of a lot of these elephants, they've been playing in the mud puddles. I've set up a second trail camera now. This is quite close to our house, and the reason I put it here is because this road is a lion highway. Almost every time they pass through our property, they walk along this road for some reason. Now you can see we're just getting elephants' feet, but it's more aimed at lions than anything else. On Tuesday night we had quite a lot of rain and the toads were making a lot of noise, which they continued onto Wednesday, and then the owl pitched up and they immediately kept quiet. The owl was very patient, he was there for a very long time but didn't get lucky. The toad started making a noise again, and that brought the owl back. And you can see that toad in the foreground there. He was in a very good position there, out of sight of the owl. Unusual and not very good quality daytime civet sighting. Thanks for watching.